right for PICC line insertion?
Under ultrasound guidance, we will identify the basilic vein. You can see the basilic vein in the box. It is compressible as compared to the artery, which is relatively non-compressible and pulsating. Can you see? Identify the vein and puncture the vein. You can see the free flow of the blood coming out. Then we put the guide wire to the introducer needle. Make a small cut.
This is the dilator.
Over the guide wire, we put the sheath. Dilator, and then we introduce the catheter along with the stylet. We break the sheath. Then we have to remove the stylet which is inside the catheter. We measure the distance and usually keep the catheter almost 48 to 50 centimeters inside so that it reaches the SVC RA junction. Then we have to put the connector. We have to fix the PICC catheter with sutures. We have flushed it with a block. This is a stick-on which is available for securing the PICC catheter. Connect the fluid.
Sir, good morning.
We put the tegaderm over the puncture site. It should be transparent so that we are able to visualize any infection, any allergic reaction. And then we do a pressure dressing for some time just to prevent any.
The care of your PICC line is very, very important. Remember few points. Wear gloves while handling the PICC line and keep the port under the dressing when PICC line is not in use. Keep the dressing dry and intact. Shower instead of taking a bath, and when taking a shower, use an arm protector. Flush with hep block after withdrawing blood. When your blood pressure is taken, use the arm without the PICC line. Avoid activities with lot of arm movements. The PICC line dressing is changed once a week or when needed. If you have a PICC line, the line will need to be flushed with 10 cc of saline. This is done before and after each use or weekly when not in use. If you are unable to flush your PICC line, call your healthcare provider. The injection cap used to access the PICC line also needs to be changed depending on how much you are using your PICC line. Also, you have to watch for certain signs, like if there is any swelling, redness or red streak near the insertion site, or there is pain in the PICC line arm, or fever or chills or swelling of the arm, you need to contact your healthcare provider early.